Hi, good morning. My name is Pastor Dave Holmes, and you're watching Leicester Elim YouTube site. Thank you for being with us. You know, if you want to subscribe, why not press the subscribe button and the little bell for the notification when it pops in. We'd love you to spend every morning with us just for a few minutes. We've been looking at knowing God and what it means to know God and how can we know God. Because God wants to reveal himself to us, and so often he does that, doesn't he, in his word, but in particular he does it by a name, who he is, Jehovah Shalom or Jehovah Nissi. All of those words that give us understanding of who God is. We've got to the New Testament because we've been challenged, or I'm challenged at least, by what Paul said, that I might know him. And after 30 years of sharing the gospel, planting churches, going through trials and tribulations, Paul's desire was still that I might know him. And so we've been looking at that and looking at the names of Jesus. And yesterday we looked at where Jesus said, I am the way. And so today we're going to look at Jesus saying, I am the truth. You know, when I was at school a while ago now, as you can see, on my blazer was the school motto, the word veritas. Veritas in Latin meant truth. And every day on my blazer was that word, truth, emblazoned on my heart. You know, truth is rooted in God, in his all-powerful nature, is in his unchangeability. Jesus prayed this. He says, sanctify them by the truth. Your word is truth, in John 17:17. See, truth is far more than fact. It's not just something we act upon, but it acts upon us. Okay, let me say that again. Truth is far more than facts. It's not something we act upon. It acts upon us. We can't change the truth because truth is truth. But truth can change us if we allow it to. You see, it sanctifies us. That's what Jesus just said. Lord, sanctify them by your word of truth. It sets us apart. It causes us to live differently. It causes us to be seen differently by people around us. You see, truth sanctifies us. It changes us on the inner part. You see, Christ is the living truth. You see, God's truth will never change. His word will never change. God will never change. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. God cannot lie. Therefore, everything that God has said is truth. And truth sets us free. That's what the word of God says. You see, truth, when it is applied in our lives, we'll have a transformation within us. It will cause us to be different. The Word of God says this. It says that all Scripture is God-breathed, isn't it? 2 Timothy 3:15 to 17 says this. From infancy you have known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Jesus Christ. All Scripture is God-breathed or inspired by God and is useful for instruction, for conviction, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that the man of God may be complete, fully equipped for every good work. You see, truth changes us. Truth challenges us. Truth convicts us, truth corrects us. You know when you've done something wrong. You know when you've told a lie. Why? Because there's that inner conscience within us that comes from God that challenges us, isn't there? You know, when we are not living within that truth, and when that truth is not shining out of us, it challenges our integrity before people. We become, I guess, less, don't we, in people's eyes. Truth is not a fact. It is far more than a fact. You see, facts can and do change. You know, at one time, and we'll laugh at this when I say this, at one time people believed the earth to be flat. It was fact. You know, the earth was flat. You just set off in the boat and away you went. It was flat. We know that's not the truth. The truth is that we live on a ball, don't we? Yeah. You know, we live on this earth that is not flat, it is round. You know, at one time people believed that the sun went round the earth. They said it was fact. The truth is that the earth goes round the sun. You see, facts, you can't rely 100% on a fact. Yeah? But you can rely upon the truth. And the truth sets us free. God has written his word upon our hearts. In the conscience, in Romans 2:15, it talks about that. You know, when we get twinges of conscience, you know, the recognition that the truth has been violated within us. When the world hears truth, is spoken in love, people are drawn to the truth because actually there's something in them that causes them to want to align to it. And the truth of the word of God sets a compass for mankind to live by. The word of God says this: as followers of Christ, we are to walk in the truth. 3 John 1:3. Love the truth and believe the truth. 2 Thessalonians 2:10-12. We're to speak the truth in love. Ephesians 4:32. You see, the truth is powerful. You can stand on the truth. You can stand on the word of God. It is a solid rock. It is something that is immovable. It's the truth. You know, we often say this, don't we, that the truth is hard to swallow. You know, or the truth hurts. And sometimes it does, because actually we know it challenges us. We know that maybe we're not living according to it. And therefore, when it's said, it just challenges us where we're at. It sanctifies us. It cleanses us. It has a cleansing effect upon our heart. It has something that restores the soul. The psalmist says this in Psalm 19, 7-8. He says, the law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. The testimony of the Lord is trustworthy, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, bringing joy to the heart. The commandments of the Lord are radiant, giving light to the eyes. And in Psalm 51:6, the psalmist there writes this: behold, Lord, you desire truth in the innermost being, and in the inner part you will make me know wisdom. You see, the truth has an effect upon us. We can't, remember what we said, we can't change the truth, but the truth has the ability to change us. truth is far more than a moral guide. Jesus declared, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. He didn't say he would show the truth or teach the truth or model the truth. He did all of those things. But he's more than that. He is the truth. He is the personification of truth. He is the source of all truth. You know, truth is in God. Jesus is truth, the embodiment of truth, and therefore he is the reference point for evaluating everything in life. You know, we used to wear bands around our wrist years ago. They're probably still available. But there used to be one that had four letters on. WWJD. What would Jesus do? Was what it stood for. WWJD. And the idea was you'd look at the wristband and it would challenge you. What would Jesus do in this situation? And maybe it's not a bad question to ask ourselves. What would Jesus do? Because the truth, the truth sets us free. The truth sets other people free. The truth of our life becomes a challenge to people. We've said before, haven't we, that quite often it is said that the only Bible that people will read will be our lives. What do our lives say of Jesus Christ? How does our life portray the reality of our faith, what we believe? You've heard me say before that what we believe dictates the way we live, but how we live shows what we believe. And people are looking at our lives and seeing that actually we live out what we speak. Let the truth set us free, but also set other people free. And finally, the psalmist says this in Psalm 119, verses 10 to 11. With all of my heart I have sought you. Do not let me wander from your commandments. Your word I have treasured or hidden in my heart, that I might not sin against you. You know, Jesus is truth. I am. And of course, that word I am, as we've looked over the weeks, is the very essence of who God is. I am the one who is eternal God. I am the everlasting God. I am the God who is self-sufficient, who is all-sufficient. I am the one who was and is to come. The God without beginning or end. The Creator God. I am the truth, says Jesus. Bless you. Have a great day. I'll see you tomorrow. Take care.